Hello everyone, this is Chensey and welcome to my fifth devlog of the Princess of Seas, Building the World in Unity. In this video, I will create a world in Unity. If you are the first time watching my video, please consider subscribing. There will be more devlogs of my game every month. Well, since we have generated the terrain data in my second video, split the world into several biomes in my third video. Create the information about plants and cities in my fourth video. This time, let's go to Unity. Read the data we have and create the world in Unity accordingly. This is an empty Unity scene. There is nothing but darkness. And God said, let there be light. And there was... Sorry, wait a minute. Right click, light, directional light. Cool, and there was light. This is the basic idea of how Unity works. By creating game objects, generating components, adding art assets, and writing scripts, well, the game is slowly made in our own hands. In terms of generating the terrain, the first solution is simple. We just read the map data and generate a super giant mesh object from it. It sounds promising, but failed. Because we run out of memory, it's hard to believe but easy to understand. The generated world is so large, too large to be loaded into the game at once. To make it work, I could either ask every player to install at least 82 gigs memory in their computer, or I have to find another solution. 82 gigs is not that much, right? Okay, to improve it, we could split the world into small chunks and only instantiate some of the chunks around the player. With this idea, we could greatly reduce the memory usage, but at the cost of increment of complexity. We need to detect the location of the player and update the terrain chunks accordingly. In other words, every second in the game, we need to check the position of the player again, do the calculation again, remove the chunks that are too far away from the player again, and load new chunks again. But, well, this is the only way that works, so nothing to complain about here. This method works well, except for a bit of lagging when we load and unload terrains. To improve it, a technique called object pooling can be used. Instead of destroying the chunks that are too far away, we could update its mesh and move it to the new position instead. This could save a lot of time and the game runs much smoother. There are also some techniques I use in the game to increase performance, reduce complexity, and avoid lagging. With all these measures combined, the game is running smoothly at around 100 frames per second. I'm happy with it. The next step is texture rendering. Instead of pure green terrain, adding some textures to it would make it much better. The approach is a little bit complex. I will try to explain it clearly. First, we need to find some texture assets. Easy task. On the texture.com website, there are so many high-quality textures offered, and the textures in low resolution are free. Thanks a lot. That's how I find the textures of mudland, grassland, and desert. In the game, we can create a mapping texture procedurally during runtime. The red, green, and blue channels are used to decide which texture to use. By combining the result of different channels, we can get the result we want. Say, we set the red to the max, but nothing on blue or green. The shader would use only the texture that is bound to the red channel. The same goes with green channel and the blue channel. And most importantly, since the mapping texture is used for the whole chunk item, we can set different colors on the different parts for different biome. It makes everything better. So this is the basic idea of texture mapping. We just need to create a shader, read the biome data from the world, and handle the presentation of different textures. The last step is to generate some plants and buildings in Unity. I'm not a 3D artist and I have never touched any 3D modeling software before. In order to make some buildings in my game, I have to start from very scratch. Google recommended Blender to me. Saying is easy to learn, powerful, versatile, and most importantly, it's completely free. I checked the video on YouTube, purchased some courses on Udemy, and did a lot of practice. With a study of a full month, pair the horses with some roof variation. Oh, that's the best I can do. After I find what my limitation is, I decide to go to unit assessor and purchase an asset. I have to admit that a professional artist are way better than a beginner. The trees and grasses are much better in the shape and color. Also, there are different kinds of trees for all the biomes in my world. Brilliant. Okay, what's left is generate a terrain decoration based on the data of the world. Simply read the position of plants. Randomly pick a model and do an instantiate. We now have the bare land covered by trees, grasses, and all the decoration models. I think that's enough for today. Please press like and do subscribe if you like my game. I will post my thoughts and progress during the development. The link to the game is in the description. See you next time.